The federal government has committed $1 billion to the Great Barrier Reef, its biggest ever investment. But it would need to be re-elected three times before all the money's spent. Conservationists have warned it will amount to nothing without stronger climate action.
Dangling a pre-election promise to snap up votes in far north Queensland. With a cash splash, $1 billion over 9 years for the Great Barrier Reef.
You know, 65,000 jobs that are dependent on tourism here. It's a $6.4 billion industry.
It's the single largest investment for the world's largest coral reef system and will be spent on improving water quality, reef conservation and research, plus traditional owner and community-led projects.
That's on top of the $2 billion we've already invested. That is caring for this reef, whether it's the science, whether it's continuing our battle with the crown of thorns starfish.
But the ecosystem's still in deep trouble. Climate change and rising temperatures, the greatest threat.
If we don't keep them below 1.5 degrees, these reefs will die, and there's no amount of water quality improvement that stops that inconvenient truth.
Last year, the federal government managed to sink the World Heritage Committee's plans to list the national treasure as in danger, but it needs to report to UNESCO next month on its preservation plans.
We've got 5 seconds before our homework is due to UNESCO about how we're meant to be protecting the reef.
With an election on the horizon, the coalition will need to hang on to its seats in northern and central Queensland, where voters are reliant on reef tourism.
Scott Morrison sees the reef as a political problem to be managed, not an environmental and economic imperative.
Labor's pledged $163 million in immediate support.
This is a government that is desperately trying to scramble in relation to the reef after a decade of mismanagement.
Chloe Bouris, for 10 News First.